And tonight, a former white supremacist shares some insight into the white power movement in our area.
New at 10 tonight, 12 News' Terry Sater spoke to the former skinhead about Temple shooter Wade Michael Page.
Well, former skinhead Arno Michaels has now founded an online magazine called Life After Hate, which is dedicated to spreading his message of being kind to people. He says he grew up in an alcoholic home in a Milwaukee suburb and was a playground bully who turned into a drunken hooligan and then a racist.
It says Rahoa, which means racial holy war.
Arno Michaels says a tattoo on his left arm is the last remnant of his life as a white supremacist in Wisconsin. He says the kindness of others helped lead him away from a life of hate.
Since Sunday, I've been very mindful that if it wasn't for those gifts of kindness, I could have ended up like Wade did.
He's referring to Temple shooter Wade Michael Page. Like Page, Arno Michaels was also a neo-Nazi musician and left the skinhead mindset after a friend's death.
He was murdered in a street fight after a concert my band had played at.
Now Michael speaks of peace and kindness, which he says can overpower the message of white supremacists.
Being attached to a racist ideology is not only damaging to the world around you, it's incredibly damaging personally.
We stand up for white people to defend themselves.
Michaels brought his new message to last summer's counter-protest of a neo-Nazi rally in West Dallas. The city's deputy chief, Charles Padgett, says it was a new experience for him. He says police can't act against white supremacists simply because of their message.
We can act when we see there's a threat, a credible threat that's occurring through behaviors and different things. We can we have to be careful to make sure we don't violate constitutional rights. So.
And Michael says the Temple shootings should lead to white supremacists stopping themselves.
I want members of hate groups currently to take a hard look at what they're doing.
Michael says as a member of a hate group, there's no room for joy, there's no room for love, and it is a miserable, horrible way to live. Michael says he gets calls from white supremacists hoping he'll show them the way out. Live in the newsroom, Terry Sater, WISN 12 News.